So this video, I'm going to share my thoughts on the TV show 24, particularly season 4. Season 4 was definitely quite unique compared to the previous seasons. Jack no longer works for CTU. He is actually working for Secretary of Defense Joseph Heller, I think. I think that was his name. And now his love interest is his daughter, Audrey Raines. And this whole, of course, the situation that evolves in this season involves Joseph Heller as well as Audrey Raines, because they get kidnapped, taken hostage, as the terrorists plan to air their execution. But that's only the beginning. You know, the execution is not their real intent. And as you can see, after like 8 episodes, the main terrorist becomes Marwan, Habib Marwan, and it stays that way. Unlike the previous seasons, where there's a main terrorist group, but they're actually not the main terrorist group. They're only a smaller part of the bigger picture, bigger conspiracy. In season 2, you know, the government was part of the conspiracy, you know. But in season 4, Habib Marwan, that's the main deal. He's the main villain, and he's so calm. And I thought his face looked familiar, so I was like, wait, that guy looks really familiar. And I was right. The familiarity comes from, he was Imhotep in the movie The Mummy and The Mummy Returns. You know that the villain that, the mummy guy, you know, the mummy that comes back to life, that's him. That's Habib Marwan. Of course, he looks much older and austere in this one. He looks very serious. He's very calm. He doesn't ever express his anger violently, which is what makes him a really awesome villain. He takes a really good cover, and the way he planned this all out, you know, this plan fails or is about to fail, he always has a contingency plan backed up. He has 3 locations which he uses, you know, and just how methodical he is, and how planned out he is, how prepared he is for this terrorist operation, really makes season 4 really thrilling to see Jack Bauer go against this guy. It's a really, this guy's brain versus this guy's brain, you know, it just gets really intense as the two kind of vie for power. But the scenarios in season 4 in particular is just kind of ridiculous. You know, the override device, why the hell would you make an override device? And why would you make it like that? So that one device has access to all nuclear power plants in the United States and is able to melt them down, all of them. So it was crazy. In season 4, it actually has consequences of San, I forgot the city's name, but that one city has a nuclear meltdown, and everyone has to evacuate, and there are a good number of casualties. And then nuclear football is realistic, that does exist, but the fact that Marwan kind of tries to make it look like he didn't steal it. Of course, Jack Bauer is smarter than that, so he's able to figure out. But Marwan places it inside the missile, so it launches like that. That is pretty ingenious, because in season 2, the trouble that the terrorists had with detonating the nuclear device was because they were trying to use a plane, and so they needed a runway. So they needed to have a plane lift off and to drop the bomb off like that. So that was why the terrorists had to go through such long lengths to prepare for the nuclear detonation. But Marwan has already a missile prepared for that, and he has he has all these connections, and it's a good thing that Jack Bauer goes to those connections to search, and those connections his interrogation skills are pretty crucial in season 4. Interrogation is a big issue in season 4 as well, because now torture is being used on people that we know are innocent. I think that's been one of the controversy of 24 season 4, that people were beginning to think that the show producers were condoning the use of torture, and making it seem like torture was the right thing to do. But I think we get that notion because we know which characters are innocent and which characters we think are guilty and deserve torture. You know, in real life, you don't know that. You know, when you're asking someone for when you're interrogating someone for information, you don't know whether this person is innocent or guilty. So I think this viewer knowledge is kind of what this distorts our perception of how torture should play out. Of course, in season 4, you know, it's just a little too... I had a hard time when they were torturing Richard Hiller. And Joseph Hiller comes in and he's like, "This is terrible, why didn't you tell me?" But soon after that, he's like, "Okay, continue." And he's actually authorizing the torture of Richard Hiller for information. Which I was like, you know, I was shocked at that. His own son, that he would be willing to do this to. But, so, national security issue. Utilitarianism, which is big focus of 24, all the seasons, now gets to include the aspects of torture and to interrogation techniques. And, you know, I find Jack's interrogation quite entertaining to watch because he's not always just about inflicting as much pain as possible. He always finds to try some leverage. You know, he tries to find to grant them immunity. And in 24, I find it really quite funny that, you know, that the president is able to hand out these immunities to terrorists. You know, the United States does not negotiate with terrorists, but indirectly, by giving terrorists immunities, like as they have done with Nina Myers, you know, that is possible. What was I talking about? Anyway, Jack's interrogation, you know, how he finds leverage. In season 4, though, I think it was kind of shocking to me because Jack hasn't been in the field for, what, like 18 months or so? He had a desk job. And he's back in NCTU, and he says he's on a temporary basis, you know, as soon as they get Richard Hiller, he'll stop. But he doesn't. He keeps going. You know, once Jack starts doing field work, he gets sucked into it. And I think that's why Tony makes a remark that, you know, Tony makes a remark to Audrey, you know, "Do you really think he'll be able to quit this kind of life for you?" And in season 4, to me, it felt like he can't. He enjoys this too much. Well, not necessarily enjoys, but he gets sucked into it. You know, when he goes into interrogating the suspects, he goes a little beyond, you know, too much, too far. Instead of trying to find the leverage, he's just so worried about getting information quickly as he can that he resorts to torture kind of first when it should be like a last resort thingy. There's a lot of interesting subplots in season 4. I really enjoyed the subplots. The subplots of the boy who with the girl he loves, and he's part of the cell, and how him and his mother become really crucial to finding Marwan, and the girl who shook the hands of David Palmer's hand in the end of season 2, how Jack kind of, you know, she kidnaps Tony, and how Jack is able to thwart that kidnapping and get to her. So, you know, there are a bunch of subplots in season 4. It's a very good season overall, and especially as even more subplots happening, you know, even more subplots happen. You know, Jack goes to the Chinese consul, and in the process, friendly fire ends up killing the Chinese consul general. And that creates even more political situation between China and the United States while this whole crazy situation with nuclear threat is happening. President John Keeler is incapacitated and invoking the 25th Amendment. Charles Logan becomes the president. And I think this is like the first time in 24, where I didn't like John Keeler. I think he was a pretty terrible president. He looks like a terrible president. You know, he's just not a very likable character. I mean, compared to what David Palmer was, you know. But Charles Logan, even more, is just, he's so overwhelmed, and he's all in it for personal ambition. This is like the first time where 24 kind of shows the political reality of becoming president. Not all presidents are really, like, as awesome and badass as David Palmer. And it really made me think about, well, if season 5 has Charles Logan as president, then I wonder what kind of political problems we'll see in season 5. It kind of made me wonder about that. And season 4 was really interesting how it tied up the story of Tony Almeida. You know, he was charged for treason. He was in prison. But Jack and David Palmer helped him get out, you know, of prison, and he became an alcoholic, and he has all this, he had this problem with Michelle. But eventually, Michelle and Tony make up in season 4, So that was nice to see. And season 4 ends with Jack faking his death, which was really cool, really interesting. But really crazy. Again, the governmental conspiracy in 24 is always crazy, that the government is willing to do this, that the government is willing to kill Jack Bauer in order to save his face. It considers every Asian as expendables. There really is no appreciation for CTU Asians like Jack Bauer, who has saved the country so many times from nuclear threat, from the Dresden brothers, to the terrorists, from biological agents, and once again from nuclear threat in season 4. And yet, what does he get in return? He has to fake his own death because the government is going to kill him. So, you know, that's the kind of appreciation he gets. And it always makes me wonder why Jack is so intent, how devoted and how sacrificial Jack is to the cause of national security.